Greetings from the beautiful state of Utah. In this episode, I'm coming to you from Zion National Park. I'm going to be reviewing the South Campground and giving you a tour. So if you want to learn a little bit about this campground, stick around and find out. Well, I arrived this afternoon here at the campground. Been here maybe about an hour, hour and a half, I'd say at this point. And as you can see, I've set up my brand new tent that I bought here for the Cactus Atlas and was able to erect the tent with no issues. So thought I'd start off with a quick tour of the actual lot that I'm camping on. So this is pretty typical, I think, of a site here at this campground. I have a few trees that provide some shade. And I chose the spot to put the tent because, as you can see, the ground is very rocky. So I didn't think this was a good spot, but there were rocks virtually everywhere. So I thought the place that had the least amount of rocks was here where I put my tent. The ground was soft enough I had no problem staking in the tent. Went in quite easily. You could see the sites come equipped with a fire ring and an attached grill, which I will be making use of on this trip. We'll check out how it operates later. Looks like most sites also come equipped with a little picnic table too. So this is basically my driveway and front yard. This is the view that I'm gonna get to wake up to for the next couple mornings. Would you look at that? Boy, I really think I may have lucked out to get a site that has that view right out the front door. Although most of the site has really good views, there certainly are some sites that seem a little lacking. So I think I got lucky on this one. Another nice thing with my tent being right there, if I turn and face this way, you could see that building right up the way here. Those are the bathrooms. And the dumpster where I can discard of my trash is right over here. I always find it's nice to be close to the bathroom in case you have to make any trips in the middle of the night or anything like that, but you don't want to be too close. No, sir, you don't. So it looks like you have potable water here, and you just operate the pump like so. Ooh, that water is very cool and refreshing. And here's what one of the bathrooms looks like. You've got a unisex bathroom. And you can see you've got a toilet that's clean. They do have running water in here. They have soap, toilet paper, as well as running water. And it works. So no showers here at the campground, but I heard a rumor that there's an outfitter right down the road that does offer showers for a fee, and I will be having to take advantage of that before my time here. Now, of course, that is not the only restroom here at the park. That just happens to be the one right next to my campground. Look at that. That is spectacular. Now, I did check with a ranger to find out if there are currently any fire restrictions here in the park, and he confirmed that there are not, so long as you keep your fire confined to the fire ring. So I do have to drive into the nearby town of Springdale to get supplies such as wood or ice, but I think it's a very short drive, so I think that's the next adventure I'm gonna go on today, is to find those supplies. However, first, I'm going to wander some of these trails right here at the campground. So I don't know if you could see that red car right off in the distance. That is the Cactus Atlas Mobile. That's where my campground is. You could probably see my tent in the background. I just kind of wandered down this way. Thought I heard running water, and I think I did. This is just a few feet away from my tent. Look at this. I am curious about the water temperature because I do plan on doing a hike known as the Narrows, where you have to wade through a lot of water. Yeah, that's cool, but I wouldn't say it's freezing cold. The water's crystal clear, so I'm sure it is clean and fresh. I may come for a dip in here. It's a little bit warm here. It's early September. I'd say it's probably in the 90s, maybe low 90s, upper 80s right now. Feels hotter than that, but I think that's about as hot as it is. But look at that background. Look at that. So far, I'm getting really good vibes from this campground. You've got the scenery. You've got a beautiful, crystal clear, babbling stream in the background. You got trails. You're very close to the visitor center, so you can catch the shuttle with convenience from here. Get an early start and try to beat the crowds to the trails. The South Campground might be where it's at. Right next to the South Campground is this little village area where you have a little pub. If you want to get a beer after a long day of hiking or don't feel like cooking at your campground, you can come here. So one very handy thing to note is right next to the South Campground, probably within walking distance, although I decided to take my car so I didn't have to haul back too much gear, is the Zion Outfitter right behind me. At Zion Outfitter, you can actually pay for a shower and you can rent equipment, such as equipment used to hike what's known as the Narrows, which is a stream that goes through a canyon. I'm gonna be doing that hike tomorrow, and I just rented the equipment needed to do that. That's where I rented the shoes for the Narrows hike. And here are the bike rentals. And also right next to the campground and outfitter is a market. I bought 2 bundles of firewood and 2 bags of ice, and it cost me $20. I haven't been camping in a long time. I'm embarrassed to say how long. I don't recall 2 bags of ice and 2 bundles of wood firewood costing $20, but I guess that's what you pay for convenience. Also, looks like if you want some coffee and don't want to make your own cowboy coffee, they have a coffee shop here. One last thing that I want to check out is the bridge over here. I think the visitor center may be across the way. Let's go see. There's that nice stream that we saw a little earlier by my campground. I could wade upstream and practice tomorrow's hike. It's probably good information to know. $20 per person, no vehicle access, and $35 per vehicle. So if you decide to go on and on foot, 20 bucks. If you want to drive in, 35. And if you want to buy a national park pass, which I have, pays for itself very quickly. All right, I think it's time to get back to the camp here and maybe grill up a couple hot dogs and reserve my energy for tomorrow's hike. So part of why I ran out earlier and went to the outfitter was to rent the warm water package for hiking the Narrows. And here's what you get for your almost 20 bucks. You get a couple neoprene socks and a couple river boots. You get to try them on before you rent them, and then you fill out a waiver, and then you're on your way. Also included with the package for hiking the Narrows is this walking stick here. I figure while we still have a little bit of daylight, let's go on a quick stroll and explore the campground, and I'll film and show you guys what some of the other sites look like. Here's another campground. Its occupant has not yet arrived. Just to give you an idea, each campground is very similar. Picnic table, fire, ring and grill. This road right here goes out to the main thoroughfare. We're at the south entrance, hence the reason for the name South Campground. So when you enter the South Campground, you're going to drive up to that trailer there, and there's a table set up where there's a ranger, and then you'll tell them your name. They'll look you up if you've made a reservation, and then you're good to go. They'll give you a piece of paper to clamp to your site post and another one to put on your car dash. And that's all you gotta do. Being that Zion is in the middle of a canyon, you get really good views of some high cliffs despite which side of the campground you're on. Look at this. There are a couple deer, 3 of them that I see. right here in a campground. They don't seem to mind my presence at all. Would you look at that? That is crazy. I suppose they're very used to people. The squirrels certainly are. I think I'm gonna have to watch out for the squirrels. I can tell already. There's a group of them that seem to live around my campsite, but enough about the squirrels. Look at that. Look at your big ears. Don't be afraid, I'm not gonna bother you. You can eat. Wow, that is such a cool encounter. Bye-bye. Hopefully we'll see you later. Yeah, as the afternoon gets later and the shadows get longer, this becomes a nice shady area. Now there are more trees in this region of the campground. Looking around at the post numbers, I'm in the 40s here. So site 43, site 44 over there, 45, and so on. So if you're looking for shade, the 40s seem to be a good place. And it looks like this is the most southern extreme end of the campground over here. Yet even more bathroom facilities. So you get plenty of bathrooms spread out. So no matter where you camp, you're bound to be pretty close to a bathroom. Come sneak down here one more time. So needless to say, being here and being able to come chill out next to the stream here almost makes the South Campground worth it just for that. Oh, I've only been here a couple hours so far, here exploring the campground, just getting set up, haven't even really begun my true adventure yet, and I'm already in love with Zion. All right, we're gonna start walking back towards the camp now, admiring the river. One thing that I kind of like to do on videos like this is just give my first impressions and not over prepare and just come and enjoy it and discover things as I go along. In case you haven't been here, you might get a sense for what the discovery's like. Site 72 looks like would be a nice one for a small tent. You'd be right next to the river. Let's go check this out. I'll have to make notes of this for the future, or maybe you, the viewer, may be interested, but the river is right there, so you could spend the night here and hear the sound of the babbling brook down below all night long. And once again, nearing my particular campsite, but look at that. And now that I'm getting acclimated, that paved trail where you could bicycle, jog, or hike, walk, whatever, is right there. Isn't that a daisy? Now the only site that I've seen that I'm not crazy about is right next to mine, where that green tent is. That's like right off the road. No shade at all. I'd say that's the only one that I've seen that I absolutely would not want. That looks like it's site 102. And I didn't even realize it, but there are more spots like down here too. These are pretty nice. Not many trees at all, but these are definitely off of the beaten path a little bit, it feels. Not bad. The view though would be even better from down here than where I'm at. There's some more sites over here. This one looks like it's site 126, I believe, in case you're looking to book. Pretty small. These are good for small tents, but you got your firing, of course, and grill, picnic table, all your usual stuff. Looks like you probably put your tent there, I'm guessing. And the stream is right down there. But if you were to camp here, it's site 126. Okay, and not far from my campsite and taking the paved trail, it looks like it ends here, and you've got a little amphitheater. So I haven't really researched to see what kind of entertainment they put on and when. I don't know if they'll have anything this evening or any evening soon, but yeah, looks like they have entertainment here. Let's see what time it is, in fact. 6:30. So yeah, it's gonna be dark soon, I think. And I probably need to be up as early as possible. I think the first shuttle leaves at 6 a.m. and I've heard it's recommended to start early because there are quite large crowds and long lines waiting for the shuttle. Luckily, the visitor center is very close. But time to do some camping stuff now. I'm getting hungry. Gonna be starting up a fire here in a moment. So I'm making my bratwurst now. As you can see, I just threw them directly on the grill. It is very hot. And some of you may be thinking, oh, that's gross. He's using that dirty grill. Well, I guarantee you, that is so hot that I don't think there's anything harmful that's gonna make me sick on there. But if you were in the same situation and that bothered you, you of course could put some tin foil or something like that grate on top of it to create a little bit more separation if you so choose. I'm just going for it though, I'm hungry. It is kind of interesting, you know, I'm looking around and there's not too many people building campfires. I see a couple, but maybe it's too early. Maybe people don't build fires anymore. Maybe everything's so automated now they don't need to. Why wouldn't you want to build a fire though? Can you hear the sound of the crickets or whatever bugs those are? Very nice and calm and serene. Be nice to sleep to that tonight. Okay, it is the end of the first evening. The fire is slowly smoldering. I think it's about time to start settling down because I have a long hike tomorrow morning. This is the first night, and I will bid you good night, and we've got a couple more nights to go. Looks like I have a visitor this morning here at my campsite. Been seeing a lot of these guys since my first sighting yesterday. They just come through all the campsites and graze while you're here. So the trail from the South Campground to the visitor center behind me is just maybe a 5-minute walk, if that. Really convenient, really easy. I found the proximity of the South Campground to the visitor center invaluable on this trip. Each morning I'd wake up, head over there to the visitor center, hop on a shuttle and head to my destination. And it's worked out very well. You really helps me get an early start and get on my feet and get moving. All in all, the main point is that the South Campground, its position to the front of the park, is extremely convenient, not only to get to the visitor center and the shuttles, but also to get out into the town and to some of the outfitters and markets that are right outside the main gates. It's made the trip really convenient and added to the overall glamping experience, because this is glamping after all. This is not rugged outdoor wilderness camping. And just wanted to give you a few final thoughts about the South Campground. The best thing right off the bat is that the campground is smack dab inside the national park. You camp in the canyon. Everything happens in the canyon here. So you have views that are second to none right outside your tent door. Now you did see from my walk around that there are sites that are more in shaded areas with trees, some not so much. Those that lack the shade oftentimes get the better view, so you need to kind of weigh that out when you make your decision. By the way, you can go to recreation.gov and make a reservation. And when you do that, you can actually see the individual campsites picture to try to deduce what the site looks like. That's what I ended up doing. As for facilities, they do have running water in the forms of toilets and sinks, no showers, and the campground was quiet, well kept. But overall, yeah, I rate this campground and my experience here very highly. I will absolutely be back. I don't want to leave. My time here is coming to an end. This is a fascinating place, and there's no better way to see it than to spend a few days and stay inside the park. If you're new here, please subscribe, and if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Let us know that you like our content. Also, hit that notification bell to stay on top of whenever we release new adventures, which we're doing all of the time. Also, you can find us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram under Cactus Atlas. Well, that's going to wrap it up for this one. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you on our next adventure right around the corner. Till next time. There are money shots, no matter which way you look.